finding their way in their new situation in life. And they all want to reiterate again that they really appreciate the support they've received from this community. And they're really thankful for all the help they've been given. I said Mike would be willing to speak with you privately off camera later on in a few minutes if you'd like. And just come to me if you'd like to see.
I don't really feel like there's any form of justice that can be justice for this, but I mean, they did the best they could, and this is the toughest thing our system can do.
One of the things kept asking on the stand was, did you have any remorse? Did you feel anything? What are your thoughts about that stuff?
I still don't feel like he feels anything, but if he does, he's going to be angry.
What's the process of the victim's impact statement? A difficult one.
The county attorney and all the lawyers were really good to us, and they made the process okay. So they let us write what we wanted. And
so. Are you and the family relieved that you didn't have a second trial or a first trial for you?
I don't know. A lot of people didn't want to go through a second trial, so I don't know. I mean, you never know until it happens, but I mean, today was the best that they could possibly do, so.
Did looking at the responses in the face of the impact you had in your life make it more beautiful?
Well, I don't think there'll ever be closure, but I think it helped a little bit to know that I got to tell them about it.
What's next for you?
Try to heal. I know that ain't possible, but we're just going to try to stay together, get along, or try to put all the pieces back together and be okay.
To me, is a benefit whenever there's a case that's resolved without having to go to trial. It's good for the family so that they don't have to endure the heartache of the trial. When you look at this type of a situation, obviously there's a lot of pain involved, and with trials, we're not geared towards recognizing the pain of the family members, but more geared towards the rights of the defendant and making sure that the defendant receives a fair trial, and to some extent giving a platform for the defendant to be placed upon, and that to me, in this situation, and in many situations, is not good for the family. So I was happy that it was resolved by way of a plea, that he pled guilty to the crimes charged, and that the family now can move on with that portion of the grieving process that the conclusion of this matter will give them. I believe that during sentencing, since I as a prosecutor are not able to give the true impact that the crimes have on individuals and family members, it's best heard from the family themselves. And I think the ones who presented them orally in court today, or through my victim witness coordinator, and then also through written responses and written statements to the judge, I think it's absolutely necessary for the process to work. Victims deserve, the victims' family members deserve to have impact that the crime had on them heard by the court and everybody that's involved. You know, anytime a situation like this, especially a severe crime like this, or quite frankly, a horrific crime like this, I wasn't expecting it. I was expecting to go to trial. And we were in trial preparation mode when I got the word, and we proceeded with the proceedings today. Still, up until the point of sentencing, unsure whether or not the judge was going to accept it, which by law has to happen. And, but obviously, it's 40% of this case that I wanted to happen. In my opinion, there was nothing more than we would have received going to trial than we didn't receive.